Students, we are starting with EVS 1, Chapter 14, Transport. So we use different modes of transport to travel from one place to another. Here is one experiment. You have to choose one place, for example, a park. And one day, you travel to the park walking. Also, you have to take your school bag with you. The next day, you will travel the same distance on a bicycle. And on the third day, take an automobile. What is an automobile? Automobile is a car or bike. It is a vehicle with wheels and engine. And what do you observe from this? You will see that walking takes the most time and you have to put in labor to carry your bag. On the same time, bicycle take a less time as compared to walking, and more less time is taken by an automobile, whether it can be a bike or a car. So also on a bicycle or in a car, you don't have to do so much of hard work to carry your bag. But while walking, you have to do the hard work to carry the load on your back, shoulders. On the bicycle also, there is a load because of your back kept on the carrier. But in a car or on a bike, you don't have to take so much of load. So using a vehicle saves time and effort. But we know that to use automobile, we need fuels. That is petrol, whether it can be diesel, CNG, etc. Also, the burning of fuel in the car vehicles emit some smoke. And this causes air pollution and also the noise pollution. It also means that different mode of transport have different advantages and disadvantages. So, by using different modes of transport, there are advantages also and disadvantages also. And in today's high-speed world, we have to depend on several modes of travel and transport for the goods. And modern means of transport have many advantages. So, what are these advantages? Our work gets done sooner. Times and effort both are saved. The trade is easier. Facilitated means easier. The trade is easier. And the different parts are now connected due to the transport facilities. You can travel to any part of the world through airways in no time. And you can visit your near and dear ones. The transport of goods, even on a global level, has become simple and easy. Global level means around the world. And many things are easily available. The lifestyle of people has improved just because of the transport. And the facilities of tourism, health, education, etc. have become speedier. We can travel to any part of the world and explore the beauty of that place. And due to the various means of transport, the world has come closer. But if you have observed, you must have realized that there is a constant traffic. There is a constant traffic on roads. And due to burning of fuels, the vehicles, they constantly emit smoke and some poisonous gases. So as we have many vehicles moving at the same time and there is a traffic jam, there is a constant emission of smoke and some poisonous gases. And these gases include carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide. And also, similarly, there are some minute small particles of carbon and lead. These are also released in the air. And an excess of these substances lowers the quality of air in the environment. And this is what we call एयर पोल्यूशन. सो वॉट इज एयर पोल्यूशन? नॉट ओनली द वेहीकल स्मोक, देर इज ऑल्सो इंडस्ट्रियल स्मोक एंड अदर थिंग्स विच पोल्यूट द एयर. But at many times, there are so many vehicles moving out and which creates air pollution. Air pollution also affects the animals and the plants in many ways. Lung and eye disorders. Because of this polluted smoke, our eyes start burning and the leaves of the plant shrivel up and fall. Shrivelam means they get shrink and they start falling. The growth and the development of plant is affected very adversely. Adversely means very bad. So as you can see on the screen, air pollution is a silent killer. It don't kill at one time, but we get various diseases, especially the lung diseases, as we breathe in the smoke. Also, constant traffic through forest area, as we have seen in previous lesson, deforestation, that there are many roads which travels between the forest and jungles. So constant traffic from the forest area can also harm the plants and animals living there. And the wild animals in this forest begin to migrate. Migrate means they start moving to some other place. And this constant sound of vehicles create noise pollution on a large scale. And it causes some ill effects that are restlessness, irritability, headaches, lack of concentration, psychological disorders, etc. So sometimes if there is constant noise, as you have observed in the class also, if the class is noisy, the teacher is not able to concentrate and teach properly. So similarly, if these vehicles make noise every now and then, we can't concentrate. And from this, we realize that we should cultivate some habits such as walking short distances. We can ride a bicycle for slightly longer route. We can also use public vehicles rather than private vehicles, because it cut down the number of vehicles on the road. If everyone personally takes one vehicle, there are so many vehicles on the same road. But if everyone travels by either a railway, a train, or a bus, so at the same time, the less number of vehicle and the more number of people can travel. We can avoid using of fuel burning. How we can avoid? By using bicycle, by walking short distance, and we can reduce the pollution. Also, at other time, using public or private vehicles can also save time and effort, and in this way also we can reduce the severity of the harmful effects of transportation. Using fuel that causes less pollution, we can do this also. We have to timely maintain and repair our vehicles so that they don't emit smoke. We can also use public transport as far as possible, and using private vehicles only when necessary. Most of the time we can use cycle. So on the screen, as you can see, there are many advantages of using bicycle. First one is physical exercise. Then we can also carry some small loads on the bicycle. It will not cause any pollution. And we don't need anyone else to drop us somewhere, because we ourselves can ride a bicycle. It also saves time. And the bicycle can be parked in small place also. We don't need so much of place to park this. It saves money, as we don't have to refill it every now and then with the fuel. And there will be less crowd of vehicles on the street. Here we come to an end of the chapter 14, transport. I hope you all have understood the chapter.